Very good evening to everyone. Today we are here with the second session on costing revision by CA Hariharan sir. Topic for today is standard costing. Hope you all will enjoy the session. And one more information for you. Day before yesterday's revision sessions material is the link for the material is uploaded in the description box of the YouTube video. Once the live gets over, the video gets uploaded in this YouTube channel. So subscribe to our channel to get notified whenever we go live or whenever we upload a video. The material for Sunday's session is uploaded in the description box of the same video. The material, if any, for this session will also be uploaded in the description box once the live session gets over. Hope you all will enjoy this session. Share the videos with your friends as much as possible so that everyone can utilize this and prepare for their exams. All the best for you all. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Annapurani. Thank you, Sikasa, for organizing this program. Very good evening, my dear students. Welcome, Safran, Nishita, Varun, Kritika, Ravichandran, Sai, Malavika, Nivi, Vishu Pandey, Subhashree Ravi, welcome. Kamalesh, good evening. Yeah, Hari, welcome Panna. Now, welcome Rekha. Nishit Kumar, welcome. So, very good evening to all of you. Jagan, good evening. Today's session, standard costing, the most important session, most important topic. Standard costing session is applicable. This particular topic is applicable for both inter as well as final. Irrespective of old scheme or new scheme, it's applicable. Many students having fear with respect to standard costing. The reason for not having grip over the standard costing from the many students is, first one, overloaded formulae. Very difficult to count how many formulas are there in standard costing. That is the first one. With a great difficulty, if the students are going to remember the formula. The second one, there is no consistency in solving the problem. When compared to first problem to second problem, when compared to second to third problem, or similar type of problem when compared to study material to practice manual to RTP, RTP to MTP, there is no consistency at all. Therefore, how to have the grip over the standard costing? That's the biggest question mark. So, to simplify the standard costing, our Sikasa team has organized a program, how to approach the standard costing, revision on standard costing. Therefore, it will be more useful for both inter as well as final students. I am ready. Are you ready, Kanam? Satish, welcome. Janani, how are you? Bharat, Abhishek, Ashwini, Pavitra, Ramakrishnan, welcome Panna. Now, shall we start all of you? Whenever you are attending the session, kindly have some notebook as well as pen, especially costing and all, including calculator, so that it will be more useful. Instead of mere watching, try to compute and try to respond, so that the program will be more lively. Are you ready? All are ready to respond? Now, with respect to standard costing, what do you mean by standard? What is called the standard Kanam? Standard represents what? Before entering the problem or formula, You should know what is called the standard. In office, in organization, they may go to say, you are not up to the standard. The standard represents what? Jay Lakshmi, Ritu, can you please tell me what is called the standard? Saffron, very good, Kana. Maybe correct. Surya, your answer also correct. Subbulakshmi, your answer also correct. Raju, good. So, standard represent expectation. Expectation is called standard. Can you please tell me, will the expectation and the actual will go together or not? Expectation and the actual will go together or not? Especially our own CA student, CA curriculum, our expectation and actual will go in together or not? Respond, Aditya. No. Subbulakshmi is saying no. Ritu also saying, Archana, no. So expectation and actual may not go together. Am I right? Especially our own CA curriculum, expectation and actual is not always going together. Now, you are also expected to clear in coming November exam. Am I right or not? Are you expected to clear in coming November exam? Yes or no? Good. You are expected to clear coming November examination. What could be the actual? So, your expectation, you want to clear the coming exam. Okay, what could be the actual? You are going to clear with the rank. Am I right or not? So, you mere expected to clear the examination, but you are going to get the rank. So, you are also expected something else. Am I right or not? So, our expectation and the actual is not going together. If the expectation the actual is not going together, then what will happen? The difference will be there. The difference is called what? Variance. So expectation minus actual is equal to the difference. The expectation is called the standard. Therefore, standard minus actual is equal to variance. So what minus what is equal to variance? Standard minus actual is equal to variance. Okay, sir. If the variance has happened, what is our duty? It is a duty to identify why the variance has happened. What could be the reason for the variance? That we have to identify. Expectation and actual is not going together. Variance has happened. If the variance has happened, mean what could be the reason for the variance? You have to identify. The identification of variance is called variance analysis. The standard minus actual is equal to variance. We are going to analyze the variance. Why the variance has arisen? What could be the reason for the variance? That analysis only the entire standard costing. Therefore, the entire standard costing we are going to discuss about what? Variance analysis only. What could be the reason for incurring the difference? That analysis only we are going to do in entire standard costing. Now we are comfortable or not? Clear? Now, with respect to expectation and actual, why the difference has arisen? Because what we are going to expect is not going to happen. That's why, once upon a time, at the time of 60th wedding anniversary, one God-fearing guy, at the time of 60th wedding anniversary, one God-fearing guy used to pray God right from childhood. He has appeared, suddenly God has appeared before him. In this 60th wedding anniversary, whatever the varam you want, okay, I am ready to give you. And he also started asking, you know, God is also criminal, you know. When God will appear before you and ask all varam and all, at the time of 60 years or 70 years, in that age, Pandayana Varatanani, very soon we are going to come and meet. If we come before you at 20 years, 25 years, you can ask, okay, I want to become a chartered accountant or whatever you want, you can ask. Since at the time of 60 years, he came, appeared before him and started asking whatever you want. Since God itself appeared before him, he has started asking, God, okay, because God is in front of him. God. In the 60th anniversary also, I am having same wife. He may be the oldest CA student, next best alternative and all, okay. I need a wife, minimum 20 years less than my age. God just said, okay, that asked too. And suddenly has become 80. Understood? So, expectation is different, actually happened is different. Why the difference has arises? That we have to analyze the difference. The analyzing the difference is called variance analysis. So the entire standard cost, we are going to do the variance analysis only. Clear? Like postmortem of work. Already happened, actual over. Why it happened? Depending upon the topic, how to attack the topic now. Because many students are facing difficulty in standard costing. You should be in the position to know how to attack the topic. Depends upon the topic, how to attack the topic. Few topics are purely formula oriented topic. Few topics are purely concept based topic. And few topics are purely format based topic. Depends upon the topic, how to attack the topic. So, because all the topics are lovable topic only, easiest topic only, all the papers, all the subjects are easy paper only, provided you should know how to attack the topic. So depends upon the topic or depends upon the subject, you have to approach. The way in which approach for CPT is not same for IPCC or intermediate. The way in which approaching for intermediate may not same for the final. Depending upon that, your approach has to change. Same manner, inside the subject, inside each and every topic chapter, your approach has to work proper. Depending upon the topic, how to approach to each and every topic. The way in which you are going to approach for marginal costing is not same for standard costing. The way in which you are going to approach for standard costing may not equal to what? Material costing or labor costing. Depending upon the topic, how to attack the topic. That's the reason students are not having grip over all the areas. Few areas you're having grip, few areas you may not have that grip. All the subjects are easiest subject only, provided you should know how to approach the subject. Because easy way to understand. Few of them may be strong in max schooling during school days. Can you please tell me how many of you strong in max since during school days? Same manner, few of them may not strong in max. How many of you don't like max in school days? Equivalently will be that. Few of them going to like max, few of them don't like max. Am I right or not? How many of you love English during school days? How many of them don't like English subjects? How many of them like science in school days? Okay, how many of you not liking science school days? So, equivalently what? Few of them liking, few of them don't like. So, it's purely based on what? So, it's purely based on how you got the lesson, depending upon how the teacher has taken the class. Am I right or not? So, Malavika liked English during school days. Hari likes what? Max in school days. Whereas, same time, Aditya not able to want what have the grip over the science. It's purely based on what one student, another student, it's going to vary. It's purely based on how we have been taken advice during these school days. The sense of what I like max mean, my max teacher know how to take the class properly. You don't like max mean, purely based on what your teacher has not taken properly. Same manner, I may not like science, you may like science, depending upon how the teacher has taken the class. Am I right or not? Even today, we can be able to remember the school teacher, how he or she has taken the class. Therefore, it's purely based on how we are going to learn the subject. Therefore, all the subjects are lovable subjects. Clear? So, Nadira is going to like max. If I don't like max, what teacher Nadira has got, same manner if I'm going to what get the teacher, I may be going to like the max. Same manner only. I like science. You don't like science means what teacher I got, the same manner, if you have the same teacher, you may be going to like the same subject, science. Therefore, depending upon the subject only, it matters a lot. Depending upon the teacher only, it matters a lot. How the teacher is going to communicate, accordingly, likes or dislike will come. Therefore, all the subjects are lovable subject, provided how we are going to what accept the subject, how we are going to take the subject, that matters a lot. Depending upon that, all the topics are the same manner, all the topics are easy topic only, provided how we are going to approach the topic. Depending upon the topic, you have to attack the topic. Few topics are difficult, few topics are easy means what? You have to change the approach. The entire costing paper, broadly, I can classify it into two types. One is formula-based topic, formula and the format-based topic. Another one is concept-based topic. Depending upon the topic, you have to attack. formula or format based topic. Another one is what? Concept based topic. Whenever you come across formula or format based topic, we have to go by way of what approach. Okay, what approach? Whenever you come across concept based topic, you have to go by way of how approach. Depending upon the topic, how to approach. So one is called what approach, another one is called how approach. When we have to approach what approach, when we have to follow what approach, whenever you come across formula or format based topic, we have to go by way of what approach. And when we have to go by a how approach, whenever you come across concept based topic, you have to go by way of how approach. Depending upon the topic, you have to approach. Then what is called what approach and what is called how approach? Okay. What approach from what approach represent what? What is the formula for the same? Or what's the format for the same? That alone is sufficient. Remembering the formula or format is sufficient. Concept behind the formula. Understand, okay, logic behind the formula is a secondary. If you understood the concept well and good, even otherwise you can clear. Those topics are called formula-based approach. So we have to remember what is the formula or format? That is called what approach. Clear? So whenever what approach comes into picture, understanding the concept is secondary. Our primary objective is to remember the formula. Or best example, material costing you have come across. Setting of various stocks level, various formulas are there. Maximum level, minimum level, reorder level, danger level, average level. Then Taylor's differential piece rate system, Merrick's multiple piece rate system, Horsey system, Rowan system, or economic ordering quantity. So material, labor and all, you come across various formula. Now, there our object is what? Remembering the formula. Can you please tell me, what's the formula for EOQ? Economic ordering quantity, what is the formula, Kanna? What is the formula for EOQ? Yes, square root of 2AB divided by C. Or 2AO divided by C. Square root of 2 into A into O divided by C. Why 2 into? Why not 3 into? What, sir? Remembering the formula itself is difficult. Where is the question of understanding the concept behind the formula? So, those topics are called formula-based topic. Concept is there. Whether you have to understand the concept, whether you have to learn the formula, which one is a priority you have to go? There and all, you have to go by way of formula only. Formula is the primary role. Understanding the concept is the secondary. If you understood well and good, even otherwise, you have to go by way of formula. If at all you want to remember all the concept behind the formula, how many formulas the concept you can learn? Maximum level formula, minimum level formula, reorder level formula, danger level formula, average level formula, Halsey system, Rowan system, Taylor's differential piece rate system, Merrick's multiple piece rate system. If you want to learn all the concepts, every formula based on the concept only, if you want to remember all the concepts, if you want to learn all the concepts, then you can get PhD in costing, but you can't clear CA examination because you have to spend a lot of time. Therefore, what is required? Our learning object, you should be proper. What is required that they have to learn first? That is called what approach. So depending upon the topic, you have to attack the topic. Few topics are based on what? Format-based approach. You know the format. Cost sheet is the format-based approach. So you have to remember the format. So what is the difference between cost of production and the cost of goods sold? Cost of goods sold and the cost of sales. Cost of sales and the cost of goods available for sales. So if you try to understand everything, you have to spend some considerable time. You should learn. But the primary focus is what? You have to remember the format. If you can remember the format, happily you can complete the cost sheet. So cost sheet represent two different types of cost sheets are there. One is simple cost sheet. Another one is, you know, two different cost sheets are there. No? One is called a simple cost sheet. What is another one? Difficult cost sheet. What is another one? Second type of cost sheet. Nitish Kumar, Bhavani. Prakati, what is the another type of cost sheet? Aditya, Chinnathambi. One is simple cost sheet. Another one is the Dharani syllabus itself. Delhi boy. Yes, Pavitra. Good. Malavika, correct. Janet, correct. Very good. Nivi, correct? So, Subhashree, correct? Very good. Archana, very good. Clap for you. Good, Kanam. So, that is called what? Varun, good, Kanam. Comprehensive cost sheet. So, there are two types of cost sheets that are there. Okay. Can you please tell me what are the difference between simple cost sheet and comprehensive cost sheet? Suparna, tell me. Sudhi, tell me. Ritu, what are the difference between simple cost sheet and comprehensive cost sheet? Satish, you can also try. Abhishek Raj. Few people can know. Now only simple cost sheet and comprehensive cost sheets are there. Further, you have to go through the study material properly. Everything is there on ICA study material. Difference between simple and the comprehensive cost sheet is called what? Yes, the front. Good. Janet, correct. Yes. Nivi, good. Keep it up. Anish, Gautam, very good. How to participate? Good. Keep it up. So, simple and the comprehensive cost sheet. The difference is what? Opening and the closing stock, not mere WIP alone. Okay. WIP only for equivalent production. Okay. So, opening and the closing. So, whenever the opening and the closing inventories are there, then we have to solve the problem by way of comprehensive cost sheet. If there is no opening and closing inventory, then we have to solve the problem by way of simple cost sheet. What is called opening and closing inventory represent here? Subhashree, tell me, what is called closing and opening inventory? Kirtana, not correct, not the mere WIP alone. Kritika, what is called opening and closing inventory here? Comprehensive cost sheet, simple cost is different is what? Opening and closing inventory. That represent what? Ritu, not correct. Abhishek Raj, further explanation, it's not correct. Opening and closing inventory represent what? Jagan, not correct. Nibi, not correct. Surya, yes. Surya Shankar is correct. Very good, Kana. Gautam Vijay, not correct. Harish Hari, not correct. Anisha Shankar, not correct. So that's why you have to participate. The moment you are going to participate only, what and all not correct, you can be in the question to understand. Otherwise, those incorrect answer will write only in main exam. You have to rectify. Yes, Archana, correct. Tanya, correct. Rama, correct, Rama. Good. So, inventory represent opening stock of raw material, closing stock of raw material, opening stock of WIP, closing stock of WIP, opening stock of finished goods, closing stock of finished goods. Clear? So, if the opening and the closing stock of raw material, WIP, finished goods are there, then only we have to solve the problem by way of comprehensive cost sheet. Else, we have to solve it by way of simple cost sheet. Especially new scheme, comprehensive cost sheet, the most important. This time, you can expect at least one question, that is 7 to 10 mark question. Simple cost sheet, very easy. Okay, direct material, direct labor, direct expenses is equal to prime cost. Add factory or production overhead is equal to factory cost or works cost. Add administration overhead, total is equal to cost of production. Add selling and distribution expenses is equal to cost of sales. Add profit is equal to sale value. This is simple cost sheet. With respect to comprehensive cost sheet, what are the format? Because the format based one. Opening stock of raw material. Purchase value of raw material. First, purchase value of raw material. Add opening stock of raw material. Less the closing stock of raw material. Balance is called. What is the balance? What are the balance going on? Balance is called Ashwini. Purchase value of raw material. Add opening stock of raw material. Less the closing stock of raw material is called Vishwesh. Troy, what are they called? The balance is called cost of raw material consumed. Very good, Shruti. Okay, Subbalakshmi, good. Keep it up. Subhashree, correct. Aditya, correct. Manoj, kindly slap yourself. Not correct. Yes, Abhishek, correct. Okay, cost of raw material consumed. Yuvaraj, not correct. Okay, cost of raw material consumed. Add direct labor, add direct expenses. Total is called, after cost of raw material consumed, direct labor plus direct expenses, total is called. So, purchase value of raw material, try add opening stock of raw material less closing stock of raw material is equal to cost of raw material consumed, add direct labor, also called wages, and direct expenses. Total is called, very good Aditya, good Subbalakshmi, correct. Total is called, very good Jagan. Yeah, total is called prime cost. After the prime cost, add factory or production overhead. Total is called, after adding factory or production overhead, total is called, Nadira, too late. Total is called, wake up, quick. Factory cost. Very good, Delhi boy. Okay. Total is called factory cost. The factory cost is also called, yes, Rama, your answer also correct. The factory cost is also called works cost. Subhashri, very good. The factory cost is also called works cost. Add opening stock of WIP less closing stock of WAP. Total is called what, Pavitra? After factory cost, add opening stock of WAP less closing stock of WAP. The total is called, Harish, Pratiksh. Yeah, total is called what? No, Sinatambi, not correct. Total is called, after adding opening stock of WAP less closing stock of WAP, total is called Ritu. Correct answer. Yes. Chandrika, correct. Cost of manufacture. Varun, slap yourself. What is this? Varun Vairavan, too bad. Okay, it's called cost of manufacture. Okay, so cost of Jagan, not correct. Srinivas, not correct. What is this? Abhishek, not correct. Cost of manufacture, Prakriya Prakriti, not correct. Subhashri, correct. Soy Sri Ram, correct. Good. So, cost of manufacture. Okay, cost of manufacture is different, cost of production is different. Okay, Varun. So, after cost of manufacture, add administration overhead, administrative overhead. Total is called what? Add administrative overhead. Total is equal to. Total is equal to Samulina. Good. Next question. Okay, well, good. After adding administration expenses, total is equal to, yes, Gautam, called cost of production. After adding administration overhead, Rama, good, Aditya, correct. So, Pavitra, correct. Total is Kublakshmi, correct. So, Vish Pandya, correct. So, total is equal to cost of production. Nandini, correct, Anna. Okay. So, after adding administration overhead, total is equal to cost of production. Now, go through the question carefully and respond properly. Nandini Gari, can you please tell me, after adding opening stock of finished goods, okay, after cost of production, add opening stock of finished goods. That total is called before adjusting closing stock of finished goods. So, cost of production and opening stock of finished goods, total is called. Good, good, Nivi. Try. After adding opening stock of finished goods, that is called. Jaleshmi, not correct. Kirtika, not correct. Aditya Keshav, not correct. Varun, not correct. What is this? How to improve? Varun, he wrote all the tests in spite of the committing mistake. What is this, Kanna? Archana, good, keep it up. Vijay, correct. Delhi boy, correct. Delhi boy, not correct. Yes, Sayanita. Good. Cost of goods available for sales. Manoj Kumar, good. Cost of goods available for sale. My dear student, based on cost of goods available for sales, first exam question, 10 mark question, reverse working question is there. Okay, you were also not correct. So, based on cost of goods available for sales, I'll probably have to remember the format. Reverse working problem, most of the students got zero mark in that question because they don't know the format, which one is called the cost of goods available for sale. So don't forget. So after administration overhead, cost of production, add opening stock of finished goods, total is called cost of goods available for sale, less closing stock of finished goods, total is called. Kritika Ravishankar, tell me Kanna. After the cost of goods available for sale, less closing stock of finished goods, total is called Manoj. Manoj Kumar, try. Less closing stock of finished goods, what is it called? Less closing stock of finished goods is called? Yes, Aditya, good. Sai, good. Subhashree, good. Manoj, correct. Pavitra, good. Less closing stock of finished goods balance is called cost of goods sold. Very good, Kirtana. Very good, Kari. Cost of goods sold. Add selling and distribution overhead. Nitish Kumar, correct. Add selling and distribution overhead. Total is equal to. Add selling and distribution overhead. Total is equal to. Shrinivas, good. Keep it up. All participants try to respond. Don't sit like a rock, work like a clock. Quick. Vedika Bakwala, try panelaro. So, total is equal to how much? Very good. Nageshwari, late coming. What is this? Cost of sales. Good. Nandini, good. Total is called cost of sales. Sivacharan, good. Kana. So, total is equal to cost of sales. Add a profit. Total is equal to sale value. After adding profit, total is equal to sale value. Clear? So this is called what? Comprehensive cost sheet. Based on comprehensive cost sheet, standard costing they will ask. Okay, how to remember the comprehensive. Nowadays, they are merging more than one topic, especially integral non-integral with the standard cost, integral non-integral with the comprehensive cost sheet. Clear? Reconciliation problem with the standard quarter, comprehensive cost sheet. So comprehensive cost sheet is a vital role to solve many areas. Clear? Good. So I'll repeat one more time. Kindly make your note properly with respect to comprehensive cost sheet. Purchase value of raw material. Add opening stock of raw material. Less closing stock of raw material. Total is equal to cost of raw material consumed. Add direct labor. Add direct expenses. Total is equal to prime cost. Add factory or production overhead. Total is equal to factory cost, also called gross factory cost. Factory cost. Add opening stock of WIP less closing stock of WIP. Total is equal to cost of manufacture. Add administrative overhead. Total is equal to cost of production. Add opening stock of finished goods. Total is equal to cost of goods available for sale. Add less closing stock of finished goods. Total is equal to cost of goods sold. Add selling and distribution overhead. Total is equal to cost of sales. Add profit. Total is equal to sale value. All of you noted properly comprehensive cost sheet. All of you comfortable with respect to comprehensive cost sheet. So if you can remember the comprehensive cost sheet, whatever the complicated question they are going to ask, just write the format, do the filling the blanks, whatever the rules you can manage. Are able to follow? All are happy with the comprehensive cost sheet? Clear? Good. Now, very good, Malavika. Milan Chinnathambi, good. Very good, very good. Sakrati Shetty, very good, Kana. Yep, Abhishek, good. Now, so we are discussing about standard costing. I am going back to original schedule. The total topic. Okay. Super Nathri. Thank you, Kana. Nathira. Thank you, Vanna. So here, the total, we are going to, total topics we are going to broadly classify into, the entire topic is broadly classified into two types. One is formal or format based topic. Another one is what? Concept based topic. So formula based topic, I went to example, setting of various clock, material costing, UOQ and all, formula based topic, clear? So, and what labor costing comes into the formula based topic. Format based topic is the best example of our cost sheet itself. So whenever you come across formula based topic, it's purely, whenever you come across formula based topic, our object is what? You have to remember the formula. If you can remember the formula properly, that is still more than sufficient. To the test, you can clear the exam. Clear? If you understood the concept, well and good. Even otherwise, you can clear the exam. Our object is to want? Remember the format properly. Formula or format. So we have to go by way of what approach. Whenever you come across concept-based topic, we have to go by way of. Clear? Whenever you come across concept-based topic, we have to go by way of how approach. So what is called how approach? What approach over now? And the second part is called how approach. How approach represents what? How the formula has been created. So we have mere remembering the formula is not important. We have to go by way of how approach. Okay. So how the formula has been created. How the formula has been created represents what? Numerator, denominator. How the numerator has come. How the denominator has come. Clear? Therefore, we have to go by way of how approach. Clear? Best example. Best example. We have to, the best example is what? Marginal costing is the best example. Mere remembering the formula is not correct. We have to go by way of how approach. How the numerator has come. How the denominator has come. We have to go by way of how approach. Clear? PV ratio. What is the formula for PV ratio? What is the formula for PV ratio? Can you please tell me what is the formula for PV ratio? Yeah, contribution divided by sales into 100. Very good. Clear? Now, contribution divided by sales into 100. Contribution divided by sales into 100 is equal to PV ratio means, kindly listen, contribution numerator divided by sales into 100 is equal to PV ratio means, sales into PV ratio is equal to what? Contribution to the PV ratio is equal to what? PV ratio is equal to contribution to the sales means, sales into PV ratio is equal to what? Sales into PV ratio is equal to contribution. Are you with me or not? So therefore, contribution to the PV ratio is equal to what? Contribution to the PV ratio is equal to what? Contribution, Abhishek. This is my question. Contribution to the PV ratio is equal to what? Sales. So, very good, Kanna. Manivasagam. Good, correct answer. Delhi boy, correct answer. Hey, Delhi boy, OTP. What's your name, da? Change your name first. Shruti, correct answer. Yes. Therefore, by way of PV ratio, you can be the person to derive two more formula. So PV ratio formula based on the contribution, based on the sales also you can derive. Am I right or not? It's purely based on concept only, no? Now, can you please tell me what is the formula for total sales now? Om Prakash. Okay, Ganna. Om Prakash. Then OPT, no? Why OTP? Om Prakash. You're cheating others. Nadira, tell me, Ganna. What is the formula for total sales? Sales, okay. What is the formula for total sales? What is equal to total sales? What divided by what is equal to total sales? Answer for my question. What divided by what? Yes, Tari. Good. Gautam, you are not in the form. Cash sales plus credit sales equal total sales. You have to come to the marginal costing level. Okay, not in the plus one, plus two level. Archana, good. Contribution to by PV ratio. Very good. Now, contribution to by PV ratio is equal to total sales. Now, can you please tell me, you know, marginal cost sheet format. Sales minus variable cost is called what? Sales minus variable cost is equal to what? pick. Yes, contribution. Sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution. Minus fixed cost is equal to what? Minus fixed cost is equal to what? Minus fixed cost. Aditya, pick profit. Therefore, can you please tell me what minus what is equal to contribution? Not a lot. You have to be carefully. You have to watch. What minus what is equal to contribution? What minus what is equal to contribution, Nageshwari? Little fast. Sales minus variable. Very good, Kanam. What plus what is equal to contribution? Little fast, all of you. Kritika, pick. What plus what is equal to contribution? What plus what is equal to contribution? Minus over now. Plus. What plus what is equal to contribution? Nishita, Saffron, little fast. What plus what is equal to contribution? Yes, Suprana. Fixed cost plus profit. Manoj Kumar, not minus. Fixed cost plus profit is equal to contribution. Now, third question. Swati Priya, can you please tell me? What into what is equal to contribution? Very good, Karya. Fast. Good, Chinatambi. What into what is equal to contribution? What into what is equal to contribution? Multiplication now. Shinivas, little fast. Kritika, little fast. What into what? Subhashri, little fast. Nageshwari. Yes, Varun. Good. Aditya, Archana. Very good. Swati. Very good. Clap for yourself. Good, Rakan. So, sales into PV ratio. Now, listen here. After all, contribution, you can able to tell what minus what is equal to contribution, what plus what is equal to contribution, what into what is equal to contribution, or what into what is equal to contribution. After all, contribution, either by way of multiplication or by way of subtraction or by way of addition, you can be the question to tell, you can derive what is called the contribution. That is called the concept based approach. Are you with me or not? Subtract panniyum sonna, add panniyum sonna, okay, and what multiply panniyum solla mudiyudhu. So contribution remains same. Either way, we can be the question to derive the answer. Now, same manner, one more question I'll ask. Okay, Srinivas, VV Srinivas, listen here. In BEP, profit is equal to dash. In BEP, profit is equal to dash. How much the profit? Little fast. Navy fast. In BEP, what are the profit? Suprana, what is this fixed cost? Slap yourself. Contribution, slap yourself now. Yes. In BEP, Nageshwari, correct answer. Swati Priya, correct. Nivi, Abhirami, welcome, correct answer. So, zero is the profit. Okay? Chinnathampi, not many zero, only one zero. Okay? Zero is the profit. Okay? Om Prakash, correct answer, Delhi Bar. Okay? Now, in break-even point, Vijayalakshmi, can you please tell me, in BEP, zero is the profit. You know the format. Sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution minus fixed cost is equal to profit. So I'll repeat, sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution. So contribution minus fixed cost is equal to profit. Contribution minus fixed cost is equal to profit. Profit is zero means in BEP contribution is equal to what? Profit is zero means, okay, in BEP contribution is equal to what? Savitra Ramakrishnan, try. Profit zero, because in BEP profit is zero. Therefore, contribution is equal to what? Very good. Navy, good. Navy also started telling answer now. Good. Nandini, very good, Kanam. Nageshwari, correct. Very good. Monika Vasagam, Varun, correct, Aditya, correct, Anirudh, very good, Kana. So, is equal to fixed cost. Therefore, in BEP, my contribution is equal to one fixed cost. Are you with me or not? Therefore, in BEP, now listen carefully. In BEP, my contribution is equal to fixed cost. Now, I am going back to previous question. With respect to derivation of sales, total sales is equal to what divided by what? Total sales is equal to what divided by what? Sorry, Sriram, try Kanna. Total sales is equal to, Abhirami, you can also try. What divided by what? Already told the answer. Same question we are asking. Total sales is equal to what divided by what? Fast. Yes, contribution to the Gautam Vijay, correct Kana. Contribution to the PV ratio. Okay. Anisha, correct Kana. Rekha, correct. So listen here. Total sales is equal to contribution to the PV ratio. But in case of BEP, contribution is equal to fixed cost, no? Already we saw in case of BEP, contribution is equal to fixed cost, no? Therefore, I'll repeat once again. So, Rekha, listen here. Total sales formula, contribution to the PV ratio. But in case of BEP, contribution is equal to fixed cost. Therefore, what could be the formula for the break-even point? What could be the formula for the break-even point? Abhirami, try. Satya, try. What could be the formula for the break-even point? Very good, Nageshwari, Aditya, good. Bhagyalakshmi, very good. Yes, fixed cost divided by PV ratio. So, Lakshmi, Vignesh, correct, Kana, good, keep it up. Shruti, correct. Therefore, Varun, correct, fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Now, got the clarity or not? Therefore, here all the formula you only derived. I have not dictated any formula, am I right or not? PV ratio you only told, total sales formula you only derived, clear? So what, the contribution formula you only derived, contribution by way of addition, multiplication, okay, by way of what? So everything you only derived, right or not? BEP, including BEP formula, it's purely based on what, Kanna? Concept. If you are learning the concept, you can derive the formula itself, am I right or not? So all along, as a CA student, you are accustomed to create the formula only, you are accustomed to create only problems, am I right or not? Now, what they wonder, Kanna, they started creating formula also, no? Okay? Now, how to create the formula you have learned? It's purely based on concept only. Those approaches are called concept-based approach. Again, coming back to original schedule. The entire topic, you are going to broadly classify into two types. One is formula-based one, or formula or format-based one, and one is concept-based one. Whenever you come across formula or format based, you have to go by way of what approach. Whenever you come across concept based one, you have to go by way of how approach. Example for the how approach, example for the concept based approach is called marginal costing. Example for the what approach, example for the what, format based approach. Clear? Formula or format based approach is material costing or labor costing or what, EOQ formula or cost sheet. Now got it, what is called the what approach and what is called how approach? Now, based on your experience, now based on this knowledge, can you please tell me, standard costing, it will come under what approach or how approach? Formula-based approach or concept-based approach? What or how? Will it come under what approach or how approach? Rekha Kumari, tell me, ma. Om Prakash Tapa, what approach or how approach? Yes, formula based one, what approach? Very good. Now you are all clear. Very good. So this is substantially based on what approach. Always remember all the what approach based on how approach only, but substantially what, that is what you are saying. Clear? Without knowing concept, without having concept, we can't create any formula. Even EOK has their own what concept, but it's substantially based on what, that is what you are discussing. Are you with me or not? Clear? Good. Therefore, it's substantially based on what approach, formula-based approach. Now, depending upon the topic, you have to attack the topic. Few topics are based on what approach, and a few topics are based on how approach. Depending upon the topic you have to attack, the entire standard costing is based on what approach. Clear? So what is the formula for the same? First, we have to identify the formula, then only we can solve the problem itself. So if at all you want to learn new things in your life, you have to go by way of what approach, not by way of how approach. Suppose you want to learn new things in your life, you have to go by way of what approach only, correct or not? Suppose today you want to learn car driving, you have to go by way of what approach? Hey, how many of you know car driving? Sinathambi, you know car driving? Abhishek, Naveen, Karthika, you know car driving or not? Karthika, Kirtana, Sainita, you know car driving? How many of you know car driving? Driving the car, Kana? Pick, 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 pick. Now. Yes, yes, Malavika knows. Malavika, you know car driving? Very good, Kana. Whenever you want to build the brake, you have to come down from the seat. Thereafter, you have to take back the seat, right? In your height, how seat will help, huh? Brake will. Hari, you know. Very good, Kana. Vijay, very good. Gautam also knows. Very good, very good. Sanitya, all great. Nivi, Nivi, you want to cycle over the car? Safran, hey, Safran, don't cheat me. Safran knows only flight driving. Directly, you want to go and meet his her husband. Now, Nageshwari, you are going to be an auditor of the car company. You don't need to know how to learn driving the car. And you are a very good person, knowledgeable person. What Rekha? Rekha no only Kurota specialist, right? Okay, public, we'll discuss later about Rekha. Now, you wish, very good, sir, friend. Good. So, you don't want to peacefully, you don't want to leave your husband in Dubai. You want to learn flight driving also, pilot. Now, height adjustment, sir, Malavika, you're great, sir. Very good. Good. Varun understood who is that Rekhan. That's why he is laughing. Rekha has changed your name, Chitty. Now, listen here. So, Janet, you the answer from the abstaining. If you want to learn car, if at all you want to learn new things in your life, you have to go by way of what approach, not by way of how approach. Suppose today you want to learn car driving. Janet wants to learn car driving. First, you have to go by way of what approach only. What is called what approach? So you have to learn by way of what? So A for what, B for what, C for what, A for accelerator, B for brake, C for clutch, you have to learn something. Clear? No, 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 sir. Unless otherwise know how the car is moving, I won't touch the car means lifelong you can't afford to learn car driving at all. Okay? Or even if you are going to learn everything, you can be a mechanic only, you can't be the owner of the car. So what is the failure that only will be out of learn. Am I right or not? Clear? School days, how you learn the max and all? 4 plus 2 is equal to what? 4 in your brain, 2 in your hand, after 4, 5, 6. Clear? So you used to remember that. So whatever the tricks told by your teacher, we used to remember. Clear? This is the manner you have to know. No, that time you may not the person know how come 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. After one particular point of time, yes, after one particular point of time, you can be able to appreciate the max, the concept being how come 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Clear? So that too, teacher will used to say some tricks you have to remember. Bigger number should be in your brain, smaller number should be in your hand, then only you can. Suppose 11 plus 2 is equal to 2 in your hand, 2 in your brain, okay, 11 in your hand, fingers personal. So Nivi, you tell what, I don't have some 11, sir, what to do, sir, okay, Varun, give your hand also. So bigger number should be in your brain, smaller number should be in your hand, then only you can derive that. So you have to remember the tricks to solve the problem. Clear? So that is called what? Formula based one. Or in what school, the baby stage, suffering, no. Okay, suffering, no. Suppose suffering's baby, Nishita, Nishita's baby is telling. Suppose suffering is telling, okay. Story, school days, you know, used to hear the story, you know, baby stage and all. Krishna Adharam story, okay. Krishna used to feel better, the butter was bitter, okay. The baby will tell what, sound will come. Who is the person, what next, curiosity to ask, what next. That is called what approach. Suppose our suffering is telling, no, no, no. You have to go by way of how approach. You should not go by way, you have to go by way of what approach, not by way of how approach. Baby is total asking. No, ma, wait, is ma. in Krishna's mouth, in Krishnavataram stories, in Krishna's mouth, what was there? Nidhi. Krishnavataram story, right? Krishna's while and the Aditya. Saffron is very intelligent girl. Tell me, ma. In Krishna's mouth, what was there? Yes, fast. Nitish Kumar, little fast. What was there? Kadadana Sikh Sundan. Mud, sand, butter, Sandhya, Ada Venna, Krishna Vail, butter, Arthur. No. No sand, nothing. Yeah. In Krishna's entire world, globe was there. Adam Maramandigla, Earth, Vijayalakshmi. Okay, correct. Universe. Very good. Kadayin Terila subject Tumburla and Napanapuriya put. Okay. So Krishna's mouth. Divya, let come in. Come on, Dana. Entire universe, world was there. Suppose baby is started asking, wait, is ma? Suffering. I want to go by way of how approach, not by way of what approach. Then only can clear the C exam in the very first attempt, unlike you. Okay. In Krishna's mouth, the entire world was there. I mean, where was the Krishna and his mother? So, if you go by way of how approach, you can't the portion to go to the next level. Am I right or not? So, depending upon the topic, you have to attack the topic. So, the entire standard costing, full and full based on what approach. Clear? Now, how to go by way of what approach? Expectation and actual is equal to what? Expectation minus actual is equal to variance. So, standard minus actual is equal to variance. With respect to variance, okay? With respect to variance, on the basis of impact on profit, based on impact on profit, variance can be broadly classified into two types. Based on impact on profit, variance can be classified into two types. One is favorable variance, another one is adverse variance. So, what is called the favorable variance and what is called the adverse variance? My dear student, listen here. It's a commonly committed mistake in examination in student side. Favorable variance and adverse variance. Variance can be broadly classified into two types. One is favorable, another one is adverse. Now, for example, favorable and adverse variance. Janet, you are in charge for my company. You are expected to, okay? You are expected to spend 5 lakhs rupees. Expenses, you have to spend 5 lakhs rupees. But actually, you have spent 6 lakhs rupees. Expected to spend as per the policy how much? 5 lakhs. Actually, I'll spend 6 lakhs. Can you please tell me, Janet? How much extra she spent? 1 lakh. The 1 lakh is favorable or adverse? Based on impact on profit, you have to say favorable or adverse. So, Janet has spent extra 1 lakh rupees. That's the favorable or adverse. Instead of 5 lakhs, she spent 6 lakhs. So, it's favorable or adverse? Yeah, 1 lakh, okay. 1 lakh is favorable or adverse? Yes. Adverse. So the 1 lakh is equal to adverse variance. So based on impact on profit represent what? So profit increase or decrease or what? Depending upon the increase or decrease, you have to say favorable or adverse. Another example. Okay. Suppose Divya, she is in charge for sales department, our Divya Krishnan. She has expected to sell 10 lakh rupees sales, but actually she has sold 11 lakh rupees. Expected to sell 10 lakhs, but actually she sold how much? 11 lakhs. Therefore, how much the variance and what is the variance, favorable or adverse? Can you please tell me? How much the variance and how much the what? What type of variance, favorable or adverse? Let me try, Kanna. Gautam Vijay, correct, Kanna. Vijayalakshmi, correct. It's a favorable. How much favorable variance? So, 10 lakhs and 7 lakhs. Different 1 lakh is equal to favorable variance. Now, listen here, in case of sales, when compared to expectation and actual, expectation 10 lakhs, actual 11 lakhs mean favorable. Suppose for the Janet, the same question if I'm going to ask, expected to spend 10 lakhs rupees, actually she has spent 11 lakh rupees mean, then it's called adverse. Therefore, there is a different treatment with respect to what? Ultra treatment with respect to expenses side and income side. That's why in income, negative means favorable variance, positive means adverse variance. All other variants, material labor and all, negative means adverse variance, positive means favorable variance. Clear, you should be very careful. That's why instead of negative and positive and all, the impact on profit is the criteria. Based on impact on profit, the variance can be broadly classified into two types. One is favorable, another one is adverse. Now, where and all variance will come? Engalna variance varum kanna. Where and all variance will come? So, where and all expectations are there and all variance will come. Where and all expectations are there and all variance will come. Where and all expectations will be there? Engalna expectation irukum? So, where and all expectations are there and all variance will come. What Divya Krishna, avanu theriyadha. So, expectation irundha, yemaatram da irukum, illaya? So, where and all expectations are there and all variance will be there. In organization, where and all expectation will be there? In organization, where and all expectation will be there? Expectation in organization. Nothing but where and all variance will come in the organization. Engalna variance vara chance irukken. Hari, budget, okay. Ritu, very good kana. Ritu's answer is correct. Pavitra, no. Slightly out of modify. Yes, Mona, Monica was on. Good. Aditya, correct. So, where and all cash flows are there and all variance will be there. Where and all cash flow, it may be material, it may be labor, it may be variable overhead, it may be sales, fixed overhead, and it may be sales. Therefore, with respect to variance analysis, types of variance. There are five types of variance are there. One is material variance, labor variance, variable overhead variance, fixed overhead variance, and sales variance. There are five types of variance are there. The last one, sales variance, is income approach. Okay? Inflow based one. Remaining material, labor, variable overhead, fixed overhead and all, expenditure approach. Okay? Expenditure variance. Okay? So expenditure variance and income variance. For your kind information, for new scheme, intermediate scheme, only expenditure variance only applicable for examination. Sales variance not applicable. Whereas IPCC old scheme, both expenditure and income, all the five variants applicable. Therefore, first four variants, material, labor, variable overhead, fixed overhead is applicable for new scheme. Whereas old scheme, including sales, all the five variants applicable for old scheme for IPCC. Are you with me? Now, with respect to variance analysis, where and all they will commit the mistake, commonly committed mistake in variance analysis. Now, shall we try where and all they will commit the mistake? Okay, they are not going to solve any big problems and all. Where you will commit the mistake, those areas only I am going to attack now. I am ready. Are you ready, Ganna? Area in which they are going to commit the mistake, what concept is supposed to learn for the examination? I am ready. Are you ready? Very good, very good, very good. Okay. Very good, Aditya. Subalakshmi. Listen here. Yeah, we'll start now. Kindly, you can also type, all of you having calculator, paper, pen, notebook and pen, so that you can also participate, you can also compute and tell, so that you can verify your answer is correct or not. Otherwise, you can rectify the mistake also. Okay? After slapping yourself, you can rectify. Okay? Good. We'll start with a small, simple question, so that you can become strong in all the concepts. Good. Take your notebook. Take your pen. Take calculator also. Hastana Krishna, ready? Good. Standard mix for raw material X, 40%, raw material Y 50%, and Z 10%. Okay, I'll repeat: 40%, 50%, and 10% for X, Y, and Z. Okay, next, normal loss is equal to 20%. Normal loss is equal to 20%. Normal loss 20%. Actual production is equal to 8,000 units. Actual production is equal to 8,000 units. We have to find out standard quantity, SQ, standard quantity, how to find out. I'll repeat the question one more time. Raw material X, Y, Z, 40, 50, and 10%. Normal loss, 20%. Actual production, 8,000 units. Find the standard quantity. Okay? Find standard quantity. Who is going to tell the correct answer? We'll see who is going to tell the correct answer. Proctor will commit the mistake, I know. Nishita, try without committing mistake, at least now. Quantity is not there, sir. Percentage is there, sir. Try. What happened, Divya? Anirudh, not correct. Harish, good. We see Harish, correct. Vineet, correct. Soy Sriram, yes. For result, check it up. Except result, Soy Sriram, correct. You missed one, zero. Pavitra, correct. Vineet, not correct. Kirtana, yes, correct. Yeah, Vineet is also correct only. Yeah. Yes, sir. Correct only. 1,000 is correct only. Yes, yes, correct. Yes, Dr. What is the answer? 4,000, 5,000, and 1,000. So, listen here. Very good, very good. Most of them told the correct answer. Very good, Kanna. Yes, Jagan, correct. So, what is called the standard quantity? Note it down. Standard quantity represent expected quantity of raw material. Expected quantity of raw material required for actual production. Expected quantity of raw material required for actual production. Kindly note it down. Standard quantity represent expected quantity of raw material required for actual production. Okay. One more point I can note it down. The word standard. Always ends with actual production. The word standard always ends with actual production. Are you comfortable now? Okay. Now. Next level question. Shall I go for next level question? First question, very simple question, easy question. Am I right? Shall I go to the next question, Kanam? I am ready. Are you ready? Little pause, respond. Quick. Nageshwari Sabari, are you ready, Kanam? Good. Now, note it down. Second question, when compared to first question, second question, little difficult, okay? Standard mix, raw material is 200 kgs, raw material X 200 kgs, Y 120 kgs, and Z is at 80 kgs. 200, 120, 80. Standard output 320 units, 320 units. Actual production 5000 units. Actual production 5000 units. Find standard quantity. Try. If you are going to tell the correct answer, you are strong in standard costing. Standard quantity at least. Try. What is the answer? Little pause. Malavika, what is the answer, Kanna? Pause. Sorry, Pavitra Ramakrishnan, what happened? Sargaza, try. Archana, try. Vinith Reddy Garu, Chappandi. Very slow in computation, little pause. Janet, Aditya, good. Swati, not correct. What is this? Swati Priya, try one more time. Pavitra, slap yourself and rectify the mistake. Too bad. I'm expecting more from you. Hari, good. Anisha, slap yourself. Too bad. Kritika, slap yourself. Not correct. Sunatambi, slap yourself. Slap. Too bad. Quick. Jagan, not correct. Try first. Answer and solve. Try. Malavika, try one more time. Quick. Ritu, good. Keep it up. Gautam, correct. Vinith Reddy, not correct. Kirtana, good, correct. Aditya Keshav, correct. Very good. The correct answer is? What happened others? Little pause. Now Keshav, enna thungriya? Signal solle. Safran, what happened to you? Divyam, try. Rekha. Quick. Good. This is correct. Abhishek, correct. Yes, Pavitra. Good. So for Nageshwari, good. Keep it up. So the answer is Archana, why too late? Little fast. For X, standard quantity 3125 kgs. For Y, 1875 kgs. And Z is at 1250 kgs. 3125, 1875, 1250 kgs. So how to compute expected quantity of raw material required for actual production? How much the actual production? 5000. Yeah, so 5000 is the actual production. The expectation which is given in this question, with respect to expectation for X 200, Y 120, and Z 80. This is for the purpose of producing 320 kgs. But actual production, how much? 5000. For 320 ki 200 means for 5000 how much? Cross multiplication. 5000 into 5000 into 200 divided by 320 cross multiplication is equal to how much? 3125. Similarly, for y 5000 into 120 divided by 320 is equal to how much? 1185. For z 5000 into 80 divided by 320 is equal to 1250. So expected quantity of raw material required for actual production. That's why the word actual production is important. The word standard always ends with actual production, actual production, actual production. Now you are comfortable or not? Are you with me? Are you comfortable with respect to standard quantity computation? It may be percentage, it may be in quantity. We have to work out based on actual production. Safran, Nishita, now you are comfortable with the computation. Little pause. Om Prakash, good, keep it up. Chinnathambi, very good. Now, shall I go to next level? Suti, very good. Subhashree, good. Next. Note it down. REAQ. Next terminology called REAQ. So if at all we shouldn't will commit the mistake only in standard quantity. Standard quantity only little difficult. Maybe one work on other way. If at all shouldn't committing the mistake, they'll commit the mistake only in standard quantity. Try to what? Compute standard quantity properly. If you are strong in standard quantity, substantial problem over. Okay. Now, next with respect to REAQ. REAQ represent revised actual quantity. Note it down. REAQ represent revised actual quantity. It represent revising the actual quantity. Revising the actual quantity in standard proportion. Revising the actual quantity in standard proportion is called revised actual quantity. Revising the actual quantity in standard proportion. For your kind information, revised actual quantity is also called what is the answer? In past exam questions are there based on that. Revised actual quantity also called right. Also called what? Om Prakash, Malavika, also called Lakshmi. Prakriti, also called, no idea. Revised actual quantities, also called Santra Shekhar Saravanan. Good. Revised standard quantity, very good. REQ is also called RSQ, revised standard quantity. Many students used to get the confusion. They'll study revised actual quantity. In exam question, they will there revised standard quantity. Both are same only. Okay? Very good, maybe. Revised actual quantity also called revised standard quantity. Okay? Revising the actual quantity in standard proportion is called revised actual quantity. Now, try one problem based on that. Kindly note it down. Actual quantity of raw material x 500 and y 600. Actual quantity of raw material x 500, y 600. Standard mix 60:40. Standard mix is 60:40. Find REAQ. Standard mix is 60:40. Find REAQ. Find out REAQ now. for the answer. Try. Very good. Swati, correct answer. Anisha Shankar, correct answer. Malavigam, correct answer. Very good. Srinivas, correct answer. Sandrasekhar, Srinivas Saravanan, correct answer. Janet, correct answer. Very good, Kana. Jagan, Archana, very good. Aditya, Vineet, very good. Nageshwari, all correct answer. Very good, Kana. So, how to compute? Total actual quantity we have to revise in standard proportion. Actual quantity we have to apportion in standard proportion. How to apportion? Given in this question, for x 500, y 600, therefore total actual quantity 1100. The total actual quantity we have to apportion based on standard mix 60-40, 6:4 ratio. So 1100 we have to apportion the ratio of 6:4 ratio. 660 and 440 for x and y. 660 kgs and 440 kgs. Revised actual quantity. Understood all of you? Need out in RAQ? Are you comfortable with respect to RAQ? Now, shall do one more problem based on RAQ? I am ready. Are you ready? Very good, Janet. Good. Good, Nivi. Keep it up. Now, little difficult problem in RAQ. Actual quantity of raw material X, 1,500 kgs, 1,500. For Y, 1,000 kgs. For Z, 500 kgs. Standard mix for X 4.5 kgs, for Y 3 kgs, for Z 1.5 kgs. 4.5, 3 and 1.5 kgs. Okay. Find RAQ. Can you please find RAQ? What is the answer, Kanna? Try. Middle pass. Adityam, kindly check it up your last answer for Z. Yes. 1,500, 1,500 is the correct answer. Very good. Why you got the same answer? Because the revised mix and the actual both are same as actual quantity. The mix is same as actual quantity. Now, are you comfortable with respect to RAQ? Nishita, kindly respond. Panna. Are you comfortable? Divya, where are you? Vanish. Try. Om Prakash. Good, Panna. Keep it up. Okay. Now, shall we go for next question? Next question. Very good, Nidhi. Keep it up. Standard Haas. This question also commonly committed mistake. Standard Haas 9,000 hours. Standard Haas 9,000. actual hours 11,200. Actual hours 11,200. Standard time to produce one product. Standard time to produce one product 3 hours. Find actual quantity. Find actual quantity. Can you please find, Kana? Standard hours 9,000. Actual hours 11,200. Standard time to produce one product is 3 hours. Find actual quantity. How much actual quantity? Try. Who is going to tell the correct answer? Will seem. Pardon, Roshil Khan, try for the answer. Nitish Kumar, try. Preetu Varshani, what is your answer? Kirti Khan, try quick. Rekam, fast. Standard hours available, actual hours available, standard time to produce one unit is available. Find the actual quantity. Just remember the definition, what is called the standard. You'll get the answer. Too late. What happened? Little pause. Pavitram, slap yourself. Sudhi, slap yourself. Kirtana, slap yourself. Archana, slaps twice. Monica Vasagam, slap yourself. Safran, slap yourself. Jayalakshmi, slap yourself. Too bad. Swati, not correct. Slap yourself. Nitish, slap yourself. Aditya Kesav, slap yourself. Lakshmi, slap yourself. Too bad. Supernostri, slap yourself. The right answer is 3,000. Understood? This is the manner we commit the mistake in. We are committing mistake in exam hall. The word standard always ends with actual production. Here you have to compute actual production. Mean the word standard you have to take. You should not take actual. Therefore, standard has 9,000 divided by to produce one product, you need 9 or how many hours? 3 hours. Therefore, 9,000 divided by 3 is equal to, okay, 3,000 quantity. That's why you should be strong in the concept theory. Or is near not? The word standard always ends with the actual production. Here, actual production they are asking. Therefore, the word standard is the starting point for you, not actual. Because actual hours, including idle time, will be there. Including efficiency or inefficiency will be there. Therefore, we have to take only standard hours. So, standard hours divided by standard time to produce one product is equal to actual. Okay, Safran, Purindhita? Now, next question. At least this question you can try. Actual production 4,000 quantity. Actual production 4,000 quantity. Expected production 5,000 quantity. Expected production 5,000 quantity. Standard hours per unit comes to 4. Standard hours per unit is equal to 4. Find standard hours. Find total standard hours. I'll repeat, actual production 4,000. Whereas what? Budgeted production, what? 5,000. Standard expected budgeted production 5,000. Standard hours per unit comes to 4. 4 hours. Find standard hours. Total standard hours. Find out. How much your name? Try. What the answer? Chinnathambi, what is this? Not correct. Good. Saffron, what is this? What a medical miracle. Good, keep it up. VC Harish, good. Yes. The answer is what? Swati, read the question carefully. Not correct. Slap yourself. So the answer is 16,000 horse is the correct answer. How come 16,000 horse? The word standard always ends with actual production. Now what is the significance of the definition? Actual production 4,000. To produce one product you need 4 horse. Therefore, how much expected horse? 4,000 into 4 is equal to Om Prakash. Good. 16,000 horse. Now you are comfortable, no? Very good, Abhishek, keep it up. Next. Now I lost one easy question. Actual production 10,000. Budgeted production 12,000. Standard production per hour 2 units. Find the standard time. Simple question, no? Here you may have the chance to commit the calculation mistake, right? Who is going to tell the correct answer? You can see. Little pause. Satya Sri, slap yourself. Good. Aditya, good. Lokeshwaran, good. Gautam, Chinnathambi, Archana, good. Om Prakash, good. Pooja, very good. Start responding. Very good. Keep it up, Pooja. 5,000. Lakshmi, good. Prakriti, very good. Pavitra. So the answer is what? 5,000. How come? 10,000 divided by 2. What is given in this question? Standard production per hour 2 units. Within 1 hour, you can produce 2 units. You have produced 10,000 quantity. Therefore, how many hours you require? 10,000 divided by 2 is equal to 5,000. Nageshwari, quick response I am expecting from you. Okay? Varun, you too. Malavika, little fast. 5,000. So standard time comes to 5,000. Good, save it up. Shall I do one more question? Interesting, Kanna. Thank you, Aditya. Good. Now, shall I go for one more interesting question? Are you ready? Challenging question. Interesting or not? Good. So if you are going to remove this type of mistake, happily consult the entire standard costing problem. Preetu, very good. Now, next interesting question. Try, okay? Note it down. Budgeted days 30. Budgeted days 30. Actual days 35. Standard hours per day 200. Standard hours per day 200. Standard production per hour 3 unit. Standard production per hour 3 units. Find budgeted output. Find budgeted output. I'll repeat the question. Budgeted days 30, actual days 35. Standard hours per day 200. Standard production per hour 3 units. Find budgeted output. Find budgeted output. What the answer, Kanna? Little pause. Subbalakshmi for the answer. Sargasar, interesting. Thank you, Kana. Good. Vijay, little fast. Vijay or 15, what run? 18 lakh. Chinnathambi, use the good calculator. Safran, not correct. Aditya, Kesav, not correct. Good. Harish, V.V. Shinivas, good. Pavitra, good. Archana, good. Om Prakash, good. Jagan, good. Keep it up. Star, not correct. Lakshmi, good. Swati, not correct. Little pause. Chinnathambi, good. Maybe correct. Vijay, correct. Yes. Very good. Kritikam, Pujam, good. Keep it up. Nageshwari, Sai, correct. Good. Vineet, correct. So, the correct answer is 18,000 units. Okay, 18,000 units. 30 days into 200 hours into 3 units per hour is equal to 18,000 units. Shall we go to the next one? Yes. That's why you should not take the actual. Okay. Good. The requirement of the question is budgeted. Okay, Aditya. Good. This type of mistake is not committed in main exam. Everything past exam questions only. They have removed the part where you will commit the mistake. Those questions only I'm asking here. Okay. Now, so whenever we are solving the big problem in our classroom, this particular literal past exam question, there only the student used to commit the mistake. Therefore, I removed those like particular segment alone. I am asking you so that you won't commit the mistake. Him, you should not commit the mistake here. Next problem, shall I go to the next one? Yes, very good, Chinnathambi. Interesting, no? One more question. At least you can try now. I am expecting correct answer from Nageshwari now. Okay, Aditya Kesav. I am ready. Already? Budgeted days 60, actual days 65, standard hours per day 250, standard production per hour 3 units. Find budgeted output. Find out. Simple question only, no? What is the answer? Very good, Aditya. Now you got the answer. Good. Maybe good. Yes, Jagan. Good. Harish, what happened? Yes. Manivasagam, good. Sai Sriram, good Kanam. Subbalakshmi, very good. The answer is 45,000. Very good. Vishpandya, Nageshwari, good. Malavi, 450. Slap yourself. 4,500. Okay, already rectified. Good. Okay, good, Kana. Now, shall I ask small twist based question? Okay, now try, Kana. Budgeted days 30. Budgeted days 30. Actual days 35. Actual days 35. Standard hours per day 200. standard horse per day 200, standard production, standard production is not standard production, standard horse per unit is, standard horse per unit is 3, standard horse per unit is 3. Find budgeted output. Find budgeted output. Find out. How much? Prakriti, not correct. Oh, it's the previous question answer. Okay. Try. Subalakshmi, not correct. Vijay, not correct. Shenivas, not correct. Nivi, not correct. Aditya, not correct. Lakshmi, not correct. Archana, not correct. Safran, not correct. Abhishek, not correct. Sap to yourself. Hitesh Kumar, STAR, not correct. Ragana. So, Suti, correct answer. Good, step it up. Janet, correct answer. Chinnathambi, correct answer. Very good. Priya, Swati Priya, good, correct answer. Jayalakshmi, correct. Pavitra, correct. Gautam, not correct. Monica Vasagam, not correct. So the answer is 2000. How come 2000? 30 into 200 divided by 3. To produce one product, you need 3 halves. Therefore, divided by 3. You have to read the line proper, read the question properly. Okay. Next. Shall I go to the next one? Now, another question. Actual output 4000. Actual output 4000. Standard hours per unit is 4 hours. Standard hours per unit 4 hours. Find standard hours. Find standard hours. Simple question. I'll repeat the question. Actual output 4000. Standard hours per unit is 4. Find standard hours. Simple question only. Maybe not correct. Gautam, not correct. Aditya Keshav, not correct. Vineet Reddy Garu, correct. Chinnathambi, missing 10. What happened? If you miss the 0, exam will put that 0 to you. Pavitra, not correct. Slap yourself. Manivasagam, correct. Archana Krishna, correct. Jayalakshmi, correct. Om Prakash Karat, correct. Gazit, correct. Hari, correct. Shruti, A, very good. Keep it up. Saprin, correct. Kana. Parna, Sri, correct. Good. Kritikam, good, correct. Nivi, Abhishek, correct. The answer is 16,000. Don't write near 16,000. 16,000 haas or rupees or units or what? 16,000 haas or units or kgs or what? Nitish. Good. Next. Next question. Haas only. Yes, good. Actual output 10,000 units. Standard production per hour 2 units. Find standard time. I'll repeat. Actual production 10,000 units. Standard production per hour 2 units. Find standard time. Find out. Standard standard production per hour is 2 units. So what is the answer? Aditya Kesav, correct. Sir Gares, correct. What's the name? The name has to appear. Suparna, correct. Vinit, correct. So 5,000 half. Janet, correct. Good. How come 10,000 divided by 2? Okay. Next. Now, one interesting question for you. Can you please find actual quantity of raw material X? 5,000 is the correct answer. Shall we go to the next one? Actual quantity of raw material X, 2,500 kgs. Y, 1,000 kgs. Is that 250 kgs? Standard mix to produce one product is 5, 2 and 0.5 kgs. Actual rate is 2 rupees, 2.5 and 3 rupees per kg. Find material mix variance. Find material mix variance. I'll repeat the question. Actual quantity of raw material X 2500, Y 1000 kgs, Z 250 kgs. Standard mix to produce one unit of the product X 5 kgs, Y 2 kgs, Z 0.5 kgs. Actual rate is 2 rupees, 2.5 and 3 rupees per kg. Find material mix variance. I know few students won't start the answer and remaining student will tell the wrong answer. I know about you. Try. எனவே மிக்ஸ் வேரியன்ஸ் நம்ம தெரியல விட்டுருவோம்னு விட்டுருவோம் சில பேர் ட்ரை பண்ணி தப்பாக சொல்லுவேன் அதர்ஸ் மே கோயிங் டு டெல் இன்அடிக்வேட் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ட்ரை 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 வில் சீ ஹூ இஸ் கோயிங் டு டெல் த கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் அட்லீஸ்ட் சேலஞ்சிங் க்வெஸ்சன் லிட்டில் பாஸ் லிட்டில் பாஸ் லிட்டில் பாஸ் லிட்டில் பாஸ் Obam. Try, try, try all of you. Whether you are strong in the concept or not, we can be the person understand the way of this answering the question. Yes, Sudhi is telling standard price is not given. Good. At least you have identified. Very good. We'll see what others are going to say. Very good, Priyanka. Little pause, little pause. Correct answer. Good. Others try. So, answer for this question is little fast, little fast, little fast. Try. Good. So, Lakshmi, you have to tell the answer. Good, 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 good. Rate is telling, yes, good, no variance. Very good, Kana, Paritra. So the correct answer is zero, no variance at all. Very good. That's all. Now you have become expert in standard costing. Why no variance? What are the reason? Yes. Why, Kanam? Hi, Sriram. Slap yourself. In this problem, more than one material is there. Material X, Y, and Z is there? No. No, not correct, Gautam. Slap yourself. Yeah. Priyanka's answer is correct. Good. No price change. No, Dakana. Not correct. Jay Lakshmi. Maybe not correct. The reason is what? Little cost. Try all of you. Yeah, not correct. No need to give. Sai Sriram, your answer is correct. Jay Lakshmi, now you got the answer. Good. Natampi, not correct. Ritu's answer is correct. Good. RJ, correct. Nishita, correct. Very good, Kana. Swati Priya, your answer also correct. Archana, why? The revised mix also same. Therefore, there is no mixed variance at all. Actual quantity and revised actual quantity, both are same. So, you will get the what? Even standard price is given, you will get the same answer. Therefore, zero is the answer. Are it me or not? Same mix, same proportion. Due to mix, variance will not happen. Zero is the answer. Very good, Kana. Keep it up. Now, next question. Good, keep it up for now. Another challenging question, okay? Actual factory overhead, 38,000 rupees. Actual factory overhead, 38,000 rupees. Budgeted factory overhead, 36,000 rupees. Budgeted days 30, actual days 35, standard hours per day 200, standard hours per day 200, standard production per hour 3, standard production per hour 3, find standard rate per unit. Find standard rate per unit. Such an interesting question. Shall I repeat the question one more time? Check it up. Actual factory overhead 38,000. Budgeted factory overhead 36,000. Budgeted days 30. Actual days 35. Standard hours per day 200. Standard production per hour 3 units. Find standard rate per hour. Find standard rate per hour. Can you please find standard rate per hour? Find out, Kana. So what is the answer? Try. Shini was not correct. Aditya Kesav not correct. little pause, little pause. Maybe not correct. Maybe not correct. Try others also. Try for now. Quick. The answer is yes. Very good. Shruti. Good. Good. Keep it up. Narayana Murthy, now only you're answering. Good. Anyway, keep it up. Vijay, correct answer. Soy Sriram, not correct. Try. Pavitra, good. Keep it up. I think Pavitra from Vellore, am I right? Harish Hari, not correct. Yes, Pavitra, correct. Kritika, good, keep it up. Monica Vasagam, correct. Gautam, correct. Subhashree, correct. So, for the answer, others, try. Maybe trying or not. Varun, what happened to you? Om Prakash, try. Soy Sriram, correct answer, good. Swati, correct. Janet, correct. Nishita, where are you? Little pause. Archana, Krishna, good, correct. Keep it up. Renka, correct answer, good. Not equal to divisible, Sriram. Soy Sriram. Soy Sriram, you're writing CW also, no? Am I right? What about others? Little pause. 2 is the answer. Good, good, good. Okay, Varun, good. Now, one more question. Preetu, good. Yes. Nidhi, good. Suparna, good. Yes, sorry, preparing both. Very good, Kana. Malavika, very good. Now, one more question. Try this question. Actual factory overhead 38,000. Budgeted factory overhead 36,000. Budgeted days 30, actual days 35. Same question only repeating. Okay. One standard house per day 200. Up to this stage, everything same. Then to produce one product, you need 3 halves. To produce one product, you need 3 halves. Find standard rate per unit. To produce one product, you need 3 halves. Find out. For the answer, Lakshmi, try. Aditya, not correct.
Sarpan, quick Asulan, Malavikam, where are you? Quick. Patil, fast. Janet, Pavitra, fast. Ritu, quick. Om Prakash, try. The answer is, after all, the last line item is changed, that's all. Yes, very good. VC, Hari, correct. Vinit, correct. Good. Nivi, correct. Chinnathambi, correct. Very good. Priyanka, correct. Aditya, Keshav, correct. Nishita, Safran, correct. Anna. Good. Janet, correct. 18 is the answer. Why 18? Standard rate per hour formula is budgeted overhead divided by budgeted hours. Okay. So rate per hour or rate per unit, I have to write. Okay. Rate per unit means budgeted fixed overhead divided by budgeted output. Now, numerator 36,000, whereas denominator how much? 2,000. How come 2,000? 30 into 200 divided by what? 3. Am I right? So 18 is the answer. Rupees 18 per unit. Am I right? Good. So kindly note it down. Standard rate per hour formula. Budgeted overhead divided by budgeted hours. Whereas standard rate per unit is equal to budgeted overhead divided by budgeted output. Okay. Good. So with this, I'm going to conclude my session. If you have any other doubt, you can ask now. Any concept based doubt, you can ask now. Little pause. Enjoy the session. Happy. Any doubt, Pranam? Subhashti is asking, yeah, profit, budget and standard. Okay, what is budget and what is standard? Budget represent beginning of the period. What you are going to prepare is called budget. Standard represent reworking the budget based on actual is called standard. Reworking the budget based on actual is called the standard. For example, Swati Priya, budgeted output 10,000 quantity. Budgeted output 10,000 quantity. To produce one product, he have to incur 10 kgs of raw material. Therefore, budgeted raw material comes to 10,000 into 10 is equal to 1 lakh kgs. But actually have produced 9,000 output. Budgeted output 10,000, but actually have produced only 9,000. Therefore, what could be the raw material you have to consume? 9,000 into 10 is equal to 90,000. So the 90,000 kgs is called standard. 10,000, that is what? 10,000 into 1. 1 lakh kgs is called what? Budget. This is what the difference between budget and standard. Or is me or not? Reworking the budget based on actual production is called standard. Kanna, comfortable Swati Priyam? Mixed proportion means what, Kanna? Good. Now, Subhashree is asking one doubt. You know, total cost plus profit is equal to sale value. Okay. Yeah, total cost plus profit is equal to sale value. Suppose profit is 10% on cost. How to identify 10% on cost? Mean cost is equal to 10. Profit is equal, cost is equal to 100. Profit is equal to 10. Therefore, 10% on cost. Therefore, sale value become 110. I'll repeat once again. 10% on cost they give, mean cost 100 you have to take. Profit 10. Therefore, cost plus profit is on sale value. Therefore, sale value is equal to 110. 110 is the sale value, mean proportionately outright. What is the cost? 100% how much? 10% how much? And what? 110% how much? Are you with me? Sometime, same 10% profit on sale value given. Then on sale value means sales 100, profit 10. Therefore, cost would be how much? 90. So, the second proportion, 10% on sale value means sales 100, profit 10. Therefore, cost 90. 90 is equal to cost mean profit 10% how much and sale value 100% how much. This is the proportion you have to write. So 90, 10, 100 represent what? 10% on sale, profit is 10% sale value. Whereas 110, 110 represent what? 10% on cost. Okay, Subhashree, in that proportion you have to write. Gautam is asking question. Idle time variance is always adverse. Yes, idle time variance is always adverse. How to compute idle time variance? Actual time. Okay, formula for idle time variance is actual idle time into standard rate. Actual idle time into standard rate. So how many hours idle time multiplied with the standard rate? It may be skilled worker, unskilled worker, semi-skilled worker. Therefore, you can get what? Idle time variance. Always idle time variance is adverse only. Always idle time variance adverse because it's an unproductive time. Because of idle time, what is going to get affect? Our efficiency going to get affect. Therefore, in the chart, efficiency variance further classified into idle time variance and revised efficiency variance. The revised efficiency is the balance indicator. Okay, Kanna? Good. Okay, Gautam Vijay, comfortable? Malavika is asking. Then while calculating the standard rate per unit or standard rate per hour, why do we take the budgeted output quantity since the standard always in relation to standard production, actual production? No. Yes, of course. Here we are computing per unit. Whenever you are going to compute per unit, always remember Priyanka, always remember our Malavika, standard rate per unit is equal to budgeted rate per unit. Standard rate per unit, standard rate per hour is equal to budgeted rate per hour. Are you or not? So rate per hour, rate per unit with respect to standard budget, one and same. If you am going to multiply that rate per unit or rate per hour, if you am going to multiply with the actual production, then you will get the standard. If you are going to multiply the same with the budgeted production, then it's called budget. Okay, Malavika? Very good, very good. Theory question. Please provide the theory question on costing and FM which are sufficient for exam. Okay, Kanna. So whatever the theory question, whoever want, you can text me. I will post the same. Or I'll post it in my Telegram channel also. Okay. So important theory question, I'll give it to you. Good, Kanna. Important theory questions as well as practical question I'll give. Okay, enjoy those questions alone, more than sufficient for preparation. Okay, you know my contact number. I will repeat my contact number: 98416-61405. Okay, 98416-61405. Either by WhatsApp or Telegram or with the use of our Sikasa team. Okay, you can get the important questions from me. So previous sessions, winning strategy for how to prepare for the exam, what all the segments you have to prepare, the summary, what we discussed in the law 2 hours that I have posted in my Telegram channel and given to our Sikasa team also. It is there in the description box, it seems. Kindly click the description box, you can get, or you can go to my Telegram channel, CA Harigan is the Telegram channel. There you'll get important topic wise, what and all you have to study, segment wise, each and every topic, what all the areas you have to prepare for exam, that will be there. Okay. Good. Any other doubts? All are happy. Nafisa, good boy, good kana. Good. Thank you, Kanna. Thank you, Naveen. Good. Good. Happy. Very nice. Abhishek, good. Janet, very happy. Good. Shruti. Good. Subhashree. No, sir. What no, sir, ma? Gautam. Thank you, Gautam. Good. Keep it up. Hare Krishna. Very good, Kanna. Jolly jolly. Why are you finishing only or coming? Jolly jolly. What is it called? Because I'm finishing or jolly or what? All along you're not participated in anything. X, Varun, good, good, good. Varun wrote all the tests. Good, keep it up, Kanna. Arjuna also wrote writing test. Good, keep it up. Thank you, Aditya Arora. Aditi Arora. Yes. Okay, any other doubt, Kanna? Subhashree, okay, Kanna? Bhavesh, now only you're coming. What happened, Kanna? GK Bhavesh. I informed your father. You are not responding in the class. What is this? No doubt, you have said. Okay, Subhashree, good. Good, good. Tomorrow also we are having program, right? Tomorrow, activity-based costing. So I'll give the background concept began activity based costing, how to handle ABC activity based costing. Okay, don't miss the program. Tomorrow also we are having session. Kindly inform your friends also. Sessions link I have posted, I will post in my Telegram, all my Facebook. Okay, LinkedIn, wherever you want, you can collect it. Very good work. Good. Yes. Here, Sikasa team members, shall we wind up now? Tomorrow, same 5 o'clock it seems. Maraj, tomorrow also 5 o'clock, ABC. Okay, Aditi. Thank you. Bye bye. Om Prakash. Bye. Study well. Aditi, I guess you can text me. I'll send the questions. Okay. Okay, Sikasa team members, can you please join so that we can wind up?
We can wind up.
Yes, sir.
Why is not audible?
Why is not audible?
Annapurni,
Annapurni, why?
If we upload any video, and for many more updates, you can follow us on our Instagram page, which happens to be, the name of the page is KPM_Sikasa, and we are also having a Facebook page, Sikasa Chengalpattu, and follow us so that you get notified whenever we arrange for any revision class like this. Thank you, sir. Thank you for today's session. All the best to you all, my dear friends.
Thank you, Kana. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, students. Bye, students.